Nobody's telling me the truth.
What do you want to know? I'll tell you anything.
For starters, why was I denied media access?
Joe's people were targeting women named Claire Matthews in the Richmond area, and two of them were killed.
I don't understand why no one can find him. I mean, how does the cult of killers stay hidden this long?
His followers have proven to be sophisticated. Their tactical skills, cyber invasion, they're on a terrorist level. Plus, some of them are trained military.
And now he's with Joey. That madman has my son.
We need to move you someplace safer.
Hi, everybody. I'm Peter Travers, and welcome to Popcorn, where we tell you what's going on in the pop culture. And you have just seen a scene from The Following, which is a big hit on Fox this television season. In fact, one of the rare hits this television season. And I think one of the main reasons it is the star of The Following, Kevin Bacon, who, luckily, is right here today. Hey.
How you doing, man?
So you just finished. You just wrapped this.
We just wrapped about 2 or 3 days ago, and not to, you know, give any spoilers, but we were out on Fire Island.
Oh, that's everything now.
It was a strange night because it had gotten really calm and really, like, freakishly warm because mm-hmm. we're often, you know, freezing our butts off out there. And then I went back to the trailer. They were setting something up. I came back, and the wind had just shifted. It had come up, and our last moments were absolutely freezing. I mean, we were just dying out.
So what happens to you when you finish? This is a 15-episode arc mm-hmm. of a show, and you finish it. What do you do?
Well, my daughter said, "You can't believe what a good mood he's in." She said he's like a different person. You know, it starts to kind of take its toll on you because rarely does this character go to a nice place. In fact, I sometimes in the flashbacks will be in a better place. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a scene, let's say, where I'm just kind of, you know, drinking wine and kissing Natalie Z, and I'm kind of like, all of a sudden, I think the crew looks around and says, "Who is this guy? This is not the actor we've been working with in the last thing." Because I'm joking, you know, yeah. I'm doing like my normal, like mm-hmm. normally I'm a very sort of, you know, I like to engage with people and I like to have fun, and it's tough to do that when there's always somebody dying, or there's always somebody in peril, or there's always or I'm killing someone, or whatever it is. It's just a dark place.
Well, tell the people, those people that don't know who Ryan Hardy is, this ex-FBI guy that you're playing, who is he?
When I first was talking to the creator, Kevin Williamson, mm-hmm. about the character, I was like, you know, who is he? And we kind of went back and forth about a lot of different stuff. And he said to me, "This is the man whose life has been surrounded by death." And when I heard that, that was sort of like all I needed to be off to the races, because from that, you're able to build a history and a backstory and all the rest, as long as you have kind of like the essence of that thing, you know, that was completely just in a very impromptu way he just shared with me. You know, that was pretty much it. I mean, he's a working class guy. He was able to track down and bust and put in jail a serial killer named Joe Carroll. And in the course of doing so, he got injured, was stabbed near the heart, and now has a pacemaker embedded in his skin. And since the trial and since having put him away, he's lost any kind of real focus in his life. He drinks too much. He lives in Brooklyn. He wrote a book that he sort of was slightly ashamed of. They call him up mm-hmm. and say the guy's escaped from jail. And I never expected, can you please come back and help us find him? And strangely, it brings him back to life, even though it's in horrific circumstances. I've really felt like I liked the heroic aspect of the character, because he is the hero, you know? But he's also deeply, deeply flawed and makes mistakes and often alienates people. And lives like an island.
You haven't done a TV series before.
No.
So what was it about this one that did it?
I had an epiphany the other day about what it is, and that is that I love to act. You know, we do 43 minutes of television in 8 or 9 days. You know, X-Men, I was on for 8 or 9 months, you know, to make a 2-hour movie. So that was part of it. I also had been, like, watching a lot more television. And when you see, you know, what are now, you know, these great kind of iconic, you know, characters like, you know, the character in Breaking Bad, and you just get to see where over the course of seasons, you know, this guy can go, and you know, it's very exciting as an actor to go there. I mean,
well, some of the best stuff's happening in television.
Part of that is that in movies the writers are not king, and there are certain writers who, you know, are able to build a career where they have a certain amount of power if you're a writer or director or whatever, but oftentimes you write something and then the studio says, well, it's almost there, we're gonna get somebody to rewrite it, you know. And they bring another writer in, they rewrite it, and bring another writer in. By the time you get to shooting it, you know, rarely is a writer hanging around on the set. You know, you have the director and you have the actors, and I myself am often guilty of this. If something is not working for me, I'll just change it. Nobody has a problem with that, you know. It's not, you know, I just change the lines, or I make them up, or, you know, whatever. It's like, oh, in a movie, it's like, that's fine. So the great writers, so I think there's got to be a certain amount of frustration about that, and probably the same thing for them too, is that they're not get a chance to really keep rolling something out, keep working on it. So they go to television, and that's what's happened. So when the writers are there, they are the ones that are running the show, and you start to find better and better scripts.
Hookers and blow. Hookers and blow. Friends and lovers will come. Friends and lovers will go.